everyone, I'm Dr. Anshu. Today we will discuss the topic active and passive voice in detail. What is the use of active voice and what is the use of passive voice? What is the difference between active and passive voice? What are the specific rules for framing the sentences in active voice and passive voice? And what are the benefits of framing the sentences in active and passive voice, expressing your idea, sharing the information in the different way that is called passive voice, and sometimes we can even convey the messages in active voice. Active voice is where the subject always remains active, and in the passive voice, subject remains passive and the object becomes active. So today we will discuss in detail all the rules and regulations for framing the sentences into active and passive voice. Active voice versus passive voice. Active voice means that a sentence has a subject that acts upon its verb. On the other hand, if we talk about passive voice, it means that a subject is a recipient of a verb's action. So you may have learned that passive voice is weak and incorrect, but it isn't that simple. When used correctly and in moderation, the passive voice is fine, and you can see this is the variant way of expressing your ideas in language. So you can see some examples that will create the clear picture. The dog chased the cat. Here, the dog, the subject is active, and in the other sentence, the subject has become passive. It has gone at the back of the sentence and taken the place of object. You can see now the cat, that is object, has become the subject. The cat was chased by the dog. So this is the difference between active and passive voice sentences, where the subject remains active, and in the passive voice, the subject remains passive. So there are certain benefits of framing sentences into active voice and passive voice. When on certain occasions, we do not want to express that we have done the work, or we do not wish to clear that whosoever has accomplished that work, in that case, the subject can always remain passive and we can frame passive voice. But there are some occasions in which we would like to say that this work is done by me, or we want to specify the doer of the action. In that case, we can always frame active voice. Let us see the difference between active voice and passive voice. What is active voice and what is passive voice? Active voice is when the subject of a sentence performs the verb's action. The action that is denoted by the verb is performed by the subject, then it is an active voice. We say that the sentence is in the active voice when we see the sentence is starting from the subject and the action of the verb is done or performed by the subject. Sentences in the active voice have a strong, direct and clear tone. Here are some short, straightforward example of the active voice that we will observe in the upcoming slide. Active voice examples can here be observed. The first sentence is monkey adore bananas. So you can see here the monkey is a subject, so it is active voice because actively the subject is working in the place of subject. The second sentence is the cashier counted the money. So whosoever counted the money, the person is cashier and he is placed in the place of subject. So that's why it is active voice. In the next one more example, you may see that the dog chased the squirrel. So you may see who has chased the verb. The doer of the action is the dog. So the dog is in place of subject. Now, when we change the place of subject and in place of subject, we write object, then it will become passive. But here, these sentences are the example of active voice. All three sentences have a basic active voice constructions, that is subject, verb, and object. So you can see in the example here that the leopard chased the antelope. So the leopard is subject, and after that you may see active verb, and at last the object. So if this structure, if this construction is followed, then we may see that it is active voice. The subject monkey performs the action described by adore. The subject cashier performs the action that is described by counted. And in the last sentence, the subject dog performs the action which is described by chased. So you can see the subjects are doing and they are only doing the action. So they take action in their sentence. So the active voice reminds us of the popular slogan, just do it. That means the person who is the doer of the action is only doing the action, then it is active voice. Now, if we talk about passive voice, we will see that a sentence is in the passive voice, in the other hand, when the subject is acted on by the verb. You can see the example, my homework is done. So here, who has done the homework is not specified. The subject is not active over here in the sentence. That's why it is a passive example. The passive voice is always constructed with a conjugated form of to be plus the verb's past participle. You can see here the example. So you can see one example in the simple present tense. I do my homework. Here the homework will become in place of the, it will become the subject, and it will come in place of the I, that is the subject. So now the object will become subject. You will see here, my homework is done. So another rule, that is third form of the verb, and even the helping verb is changed, that we will change according to the tense in which we are framing active to passive voice sentence. Some passive voice examples elaborate that the action which is done by the subject is denoted in a different way. You may see here the examples, bananas are adored by monkeys. So now monkeys are the subject, but still they are in place of object, you can see here. So now the object has become the subject and the subject has become object. So you can see monkeys adore bananas and bananas are adored by monkeys. The active sentence consists of monkeys as a subject, and afterwards you may see adore as a verb and then the object bananas. But on the other hand, in the passive construction, you may see that banana, the object has become the subject, and after that, the helping verb are has come, and adore, a form of the be plus the past participle is here. By, the preposition is also added in the sentence before the subject monkeys, that is now that has become object. So making the sentence passive flipped the structure and necessitated the preposition by. In fact, all three of the transformed sentences above required the addition of by. So you may see these are the changes that we may have done here in the passive constructions. The cake was eaten by the dog. This is the passive construction, and here you may see whosoever eaten the cake, the subject has become passive and it has gone in place of object. So that's why this is a passive construction. Some specific use of active and passive voice, we need to know why we should use active voice. What is the reason behind using passive voice? Once if we are well aware of their usage, then only we can actively use them in our day-to-day life. Use of active and passive voice, we can see that active voice conveys a strong, clear tone and the passive voice is subtler and weaker. Here are some good examples. You can see that don't use the passive voice just because you think it sounds a bit fancier than the active voice. Once if there is any requirement of using passive voice only, then you use it. Otherwise, if it is not required, don't only use passive voice just to make the sentence creative, or if you wish to convey in a different way, only for that reason, you need not to use passive voice. There can be some specific reason behind usage of active and passive voices. There are times the passive voice is useful and called for. Take the squirrel was chased by the dog, for example. That sentence construction would be helpful if the squirrel were the focus of your writing and not the dog. So this, if you wish to do, you can always go for a passive voice. A good rule of thumb is to try to put the majority of your sentence in the active voice, unless you truly cannot write your sentence in any other way. So there are some examples. You can see Anna painted the house. That means Anna is here. The person, the subject who has painted, or the verb or the action is done by Anna. And Anna is in place of subject. So that's why it is active voice. But now in the another example, you may see that the house was painted by Anna. So now Anna has become passive and it is placed in place of the object and it has gone at the last. So now the important place is entertained by the house, which is subject. So that's why when subject becomes passive and object becomes active, that is called passive voice. Is voice? The voice of a verb tells whether the subject is the sentence, performs or receives the action. If the subject performs the action, that is active voice. If the subject receives the action, it is a passive voice. You can see the example, birds build nests. So this is the example of active voice. And the another example is nests are built by birds. So here the birds, the one who built the nest has gone in place of object. So we can always say this is a passive voice or a passive construction. Now we can see type of voice. Active voice, the subject performs the action expressed by the verb. You can always see one example so that it can become more clear, such as Ram killed Ravana. So you can see here the one who has killed, or the doer of the action, Ram, is in place of subject. So that's why it is active voice. When the what subject does, or when the subject is active, it is active voice. When the focus is on the action, then and subject has become passive, then it is a passive voice. Passive voice, the subject receives the action that is expressed by the verb. And in use, we can see when the action is the focus, not the subject, and when the doer is unknown, in that case, we can always say it is a passive voice. So we need to understand the rules, the importance, the use, and how we can always convey our messages in which voice, that is really essential. Some rules of conversation from active to passive voice. Now, first rule says that bring the object first in place of the subject. And the second rule says that choose correct be form of the verb. And the third rule says that change the verb into past participle. Add by before the subject, that means before the object that has become subject now. So So first of all, you need to identify the subject, the verb and the object, that is S, V, O. So change the object into subject, and after that put the suitable helping verb, or even you can say auxiliary verb. And the third point, next point is change the verb into past participle of the verb. You can see one example so that it can become more clear. Sameer wrote a letter. So Sameer in the passive construction, you may see, has gone at the last, and a letter object has become subject. So you can see a letter, then you will see the auxiliary verb was, and past participle written, and after that by, and at last you may see the subject that has become object, Sameer. So a letter was written by Sameer. So you can see the construction in passive is object, auxiliary verb, past participle, by, and then the subject. So in this way, by following this rule, we can always frame a passive construction. So in this way, today we discussed about various passive constructions, and in the upcoming session, we will discuss about certain rules for each and every tense, how we can change active voice into passive voice. Along with that, some tips when and where to use active voice and how to avoid the errors that we may easily commit while changing the sentences from active voice to passive voice.